similar ages, it's Mlambo versus Moya, Ireland versus Sweden, in this all-European featherweight final.
The featherweight final, Frans Mlambo from Ireland against Joel Moya from Sweden, who's been here before, Chris. Will it be an advantage to him?
Absolutely. I mean, Joel knows what it takes to compete on a world stage like this in Las Vegas, and more importantly, has the experience of going through tournament-style fighting. That being said, of course, Frans Mlambo has some skills that are going to put him in a task and position by which he has to cut down that reach advantage and try to get to the mat, to get the fight to the mat where he believes he'll be able to take it.
Now, Joel, very nice transition from the semi-final to the final. Didn't have to really work that hard. Will that give him an advantage as well?
Possibly. I mean, if we consider the fact that Mlambo had to go through a pretty tough task last time around in Nicholas Ott. I think what we're going to see, though, is Moya try to get this down early, and he's off to a pretty good start by closing the distance finally against Mlambo.
Yes, the silver medalist last year, as he said in his pre-fight interview, looking to go for gold this time.
And I think, as we've seen so far with Joel's tactics, that he did a really good job of avoiding damage from Mlambo at a distance. I mean, a guy like that can spark you out with just a moment's notice. And Mlambo needs to be careful to try to move away from getting cut off in the ring here.
Good punches, though, from Mlambo. But again, as you said, nice head movement from Joel Moya. And that's what I want to pick you up on. You said what impressed you was the way he avoids damage. In a tournament situation like that, it's imperative. But now in the final, it's just that single fight again.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a prerequisite for success. It's a mandate to try to be able to get through what is a shark tank of tough competition in this division. We've seen some of the most competitive fights thus far in Las Vegas here, and it's all come down to this big final matchup.
Now, I think Mlambo got Joel's attention there. It was a blistering set of punches, and immediately Joel tied him up and took him down.
Yeah, beautiful. And didn't really have to worry too much about having to get stuck in a guard, where when you look at a guy like Frans Mlambo, he's going to be tough to pop open. He's got long limbs, he's able to have good movement and good leverage, and let's see what Joel can do with this.
Having had a good look at the two in this opening round here, it seems to me, without being too cliched, that Frans will want to keep it upright, where Joel will want to take it more to the ground.
Completely. I mean, you saw the way that Joel was looking to go neon belly there, realized that Frans was going to time a scramble and get back up. Joel went far side and tried to maintain position. Obviously, what he didn't realize was that Frans knew he was going to make that movement, and Frans got right back up. And now he's in stalking mode.
Well, that was the danger for Joel. You saw Frans Mlambo, beautiful right hand started that. Very dangerous upright. As you see here, what I like is the way the man punches on the turn.
Absolutely. I mean, it was a nice right knee to actually, as you said, turning his full body into getting a good connection with that left hook. But man, Joel can take it. Moya is a tough guy indeed.
Yes, I love this contrast of styles. You can see Frans Mlambo inside the last 10 seconds now, looking to finish strongly, looking to keep it upright, whereas we know Moya will want to take it to the ground early in round two. We saw from round one a real difference in styles here, and we saw the danger of Frans Mlambo's punches and then Joel Moya wanting to take it to ground. I can see that continuing this way in the second, Chris.
Malcolm, those were punishing shots. I mean, a guy like Frans Mlambo does not have to land a great volume of strikes to really put you into trouble. He gets such great snap and extension on those long punches. There you go, that's the one, the 1-2 combination. Even if it just shows the jab a little bit and then turns into a corking right hand, that can be good night Irene. And look at that right round kick to the body, beautiful stuff.
It's bread and butter, but it's working. He steps in nice, as you said, crisp right and left, and another nice right hand.
Man, big connections from the Irishman surging forward. This man looks unstoppable in round two, and Joel hasn't had a reply yet, Malcolm.
And the problem for him is he's circling towards the dangerous right hand. He must reverse that. He must circle the opposite way because Frans is leading him towards that big right hand.
And with a probing inside leg kick, that's going to make Joel move off in that direction. I think he's going to try and set him up for that one again, Malcolm.
Yes, Joel's got to be careful here. I felt it was a very even across the 3 minutes opening round. But Frans has started on fire here in the second, walking his man down, throwing the heavy punches. And Joel must start thinking about which way he's going to go. Again, I love the way Frans jumps into those punches.
Yeah, I mean, Mlambo is definitely loosening up. I mean, if you looked at like the last few combinations he threw in the end of round one, that was the indicator of what was to come. And we're seeing, as I said, this looseness unfold here into round two, and it's going entirely his way thus far. But now, as we say, Joel with the clinch, dropping underneath for a takedown. may look to run the pipe here away from the cage on the inside of this head inside single, but oh, he swaps to the double. That is nice. He knew he could turn away from the cage. Franz read that, and so Joel, the Swede, jumped to the double. Awesome stuff.
And look, Franz gets himself back upright as well. I think he's realized that when it comes to the upright exchanges, he's got a real advantage.
And Joel using solid head pressure. That is painful. You can see the way he's pressing his head underneath the chin and to the cheekbones of Frans Mlambo. This is the type of fight that the Swedish man needs to take this one from him.
Yes, because at the moment we're inside the last minute and Joel hasn't had the opportunities on the ground that he had in the opening round. And I feel for a good portion of this second round, Franz was able to impress the judges with his punching power, with his movement. And again, beautiful turn. And you feel this is where Franz wants to be, in the middle of the cage here.
And speaking about what Franz was able to do, Joel was unable after clinching with that gable grip to get that takedown.
So nice right to the body as well from Franz. Varying it up beautifully, comes downstairs with the right hand to the body, left hook to the head. And this is where I think there's been the real difference between the two men in this second round.
Absolutely. I mean, you're looking at a situation where Franz, halfway through this round, had to defend a real surge from the Swedish man. But now he's further established his dominance and is coming out on top here, Malcolm.
That's right. We're counting out this second round. And I think after the first one being so close, this one is definitely in favor of the Irishman. Third and final round of the featherweight title fight. And Chris, a world title at stake. I think Frans Mlambo is doing the right thing here.
This has been a world-class journey for these athletes in Las Vegas. Several days of grueling combative sport action, but it's all come down to one final round for these two here in the biggest show, the biggest amateur world tournament there is. This is just as good as it gets.
Oh, and a beautiful right hand again from Frans Mlambo. That, to me, across round two and the beginning of round three, has been the difference between the two men. Mlambo doesn't just stalk, he lets it go. How many times, Chris, have we seen people do the right thing, cut the ring down or the cage down, but not fire off? Frans Mlambo, when he gets in range, he's so dangerous.
Such a gifted athlete. I mean, he just has a myriad of combinations. And as you said, it's not holding back. And the crowd showing very great appreciation for that here in our venue at the Sands. This is just such a great bout with so much future talent on display.
Now, Joel Moyer faked the strike, went for the double leg, but Frans Mlambo saw it cleanly. And you feel the longer he keeps him up, Chris, the longer this is going to go his way.
Yeah, absolutely. That left hook landed very cleanly there. And I feel at a moment's notice, this could move towards a finish in favor of the Irishman if Joel can't get this down. You can see him grimace with every single shot. Bam, on cue, big takedown. That is huge.
Key point in the round as well, Chris. Halfway through, perfect time to do it. But now he really has to work his game plan.
Oh, wow, and a big pass. That was a lazy guard retention attempt from the Irishman. And Joel having his biggest opportunity, in my opinion, of this entire bout. We're halfway through, and he has one of the very best positions he's been able to get so far in this match.
What happens next is key, isn't it, Chris? Because we had Mlambo really strong in the second, really strong in the opening half of this third. But with over a minute left, if Joel can really work here, it could be open again.
This is surreal. Full mount here. And a big chance for a finish. Joel's got to go for it, though. The Swedish cannot wait around. That's what he needs to do. He needs to pin, in my opinion, the Irishman to the mat and then try and control positions and land strikes.
Having said that, Franz pops out and immediately throws the big right hand again. And I think that's a wasted opportunity and possibly the last opportunity for Joel Moyer here. He was runner-up. He got the silver last year. He could be facing that again this year. Double heartbreak, Chris.
Perfect timing from Frans Mlambo and just showing great flexibility and being able to escape what was a pretty tough position with that guy on top. I mean, Joel had a very tight mount, but now Frans is back to the pattern that we've seen thus far in this bout.
Oh, and another stinging right hand through the channel there with 20 seconds to go. Joel Moyer looks frustrated here. His shoot attempts look ragged, Chris.
Well, when a guy stuffs their takedowns time and time and time again and escapes on point the way Frans Mlambo has, it's just a thing of pure beauty to see another martial artist like this coming out on this world stage in Vegas.
Yes, and pinpoint there. And now I feel that for the second time running, Joel Moyer is going to be the bridesmaid, not the bride.
All three judges scored the bout 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision and IMMAF World Amateur Featherweight Champion, the red corner representing Team Ireland, Frans Mlambo. Taking taking home the bronze to the Ukraine, Yuri Osiev. And taking the bronze to France, Nicholas Ott. Taking the silver, Team Sweden, Joe Moyer. And bringing the gold home to Ireland, Frans Mlambo.